guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So you've caught us kind of mid-session. So we'll take you through the rest of our session. Well, I'm at Offseason Rotherham today with my training partner, Fiona. And we are here to see Meg. I haven't seen Meg since literally about 2 weeks after my show in December. So we're here to have a chat, let you guys know where I'm at, what's going on. So yeah.
That's it, head. Good, solid. Yes, strong. Good. Yes.
So, I keep doing this thing where like I will finish a set and I'll just feel like it was like the most rubbish set. And it's just like not a good set. And she'll say to me, oh, how did you feel that? Like at the end, and I'm like, it was all right. I look back and I'm like, it was good. It was a really good set. It's just something I keep doing at the moment. I feel like I'm probably going through a phase where I've got like the most self-doubt in like everything I do. It's so annoying, but that's what I'm gonna speak to Meg about as well today. It's not good, I don't know where it's come from.
Yeah.
Good, drive back through the hips. Feel good?
Yeah, felt all right, actually.
I will speak a little bit more on here in a bit. I'm just gonna like get my head down and get into the session. And I'm gonna explain what I've been feeling in a bit when I do speak to Meg, because, yeah. If I look negative, I'm not.
Good. Stay in it. Nice. Solid. Yes. Come on, come on. Stay with it now. Drive.
Stay tight, let's go. So a common mistake you'll see with this is people, as much as we want to push our glutes back during the movement, quite often people will push their glutes up, and that creates an arch in the back, and this is where you're not bracing your core. So you'll quite often see people head up, and they're, instead of pushing like back, they're kind of pushing up, and as they're pulling up, creating an hyperextending at the top, which is not what we want to do. So we don't want to hyperextend at the top. We don't want to, basically like that. So the way that you want to perform in a stiff-legged deadlift is your feet, you want them just about shoulder width apart. You're going to grip the bar, and I always say bend the bar around your body. This helps your lats to engage, which keeps your upper back tight. Then you want to think about your core. Now, when I say brace your core, you want to think like someone's punching you in the stomach. So your core is like tense the whole way through. So it's like nice and tight instead of not. So what we're gonna do is when we do lean over, we're gonna bend the bar around our body, which locks our lats in. We're gonna brace the core, which takes away the glutes being lifted. We're going to keep our chin to chest. We're going to lock in. And then that's when you're going to start the movement. Instead of hyperextending at the top, we're going to literally aim to keep our chest slightly over our hips here. So we're still tight with our arms in exactly the same position. We're aiming to run the bar down our body and then back up. We want a slight bend in our knees and we want to just be pushing back like, so you're going to be almost like feeling like you're going to tilt back, but you're not. You want to be squeezing the floor with the whole of your foot. And this is why I always advise doing it without shoes on. So you can really squeeze the floor with your toes. And that is how you perform a stiff-legged deadlift. Thank you.
Perfect. That's it.
Ah.
Drive, good. Solid set. Good, just seeing it. Yes, yes, yes. Again. That's it, control. Power. Yes.
Really, really good. Two. Good. 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 You. Good. That was all you. Really good.
Get your back off set. Perfect. Ooh. it. Yes, that's it. Yes, keep going. Breathe, that's it. Press hard, press hard. Lovely. And again, let's go.
Right, let's go. So this time we want to spend a bit longer, well, at the bottom, but a bit less time at the top. There you go. Really good. 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 Power and then slow. Good. Good. Power on the way up. Slow on the way down. Good. Good. One, two. Good. Slow on the way down. Good. Slow on the way down. Good. Well done. The aim of this exercise is we're biting the glutes here. So when we are on the leg press, to bias, the glutes, we want to take our feet higher than what we would if we were targeting the quads. This targets the quads because when the weight comes back, my knee will be over my toes. To bias the glute, when the weight comes back, it will stay like, my shins will stay vertical. So you won't see my knee come over my toe, it will stay behind. What we're doing is we're locking in using the handles. We are not leaning forward too much. We're not sitting all the way back. We're nice and tight here, keeping everything locked and braced. We're driving through the heels here as well, but making sure that we put our full foot to the floor. We don't want to spend too long at the top of the rep, but we want to come down nice and slow before we power up for the next rep. When the weight is coming back down towards us, we're breathing in. As we press out, we get to power out as we breathe out. hole. That literally gets you. I always find that literally sneaks up on you and all of a sudden you're like...
Perfect. Keep it tight. Good. Yes, yes. Nice.
I don't know about this.
No.
Maybe.
Yes, good. Sit, control. That's it, that's it. Yes. Thank you.
Just go, Fiona. Good. Got it.
Sit. Come on. All the way, all the way, all the way, all the way. Good. Control the negative. Here we go, here we go. Drive, 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 drive. Yes. Control. Let's go, let's go. All the way, all the way.
Oh, yeah.
Here we go.
No, not yet.
No, I'm just going to stop. Oh, don't go
too high. Down.
Just a tiny bit. You there. There you go. There. That's it. There. Perfect. Yes. That's it. There. Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, and again.
With me.
There. Control.
It's a lot more in your glute. Your upper body's always going to look a bit flatter when you're in off season. Definitely don't need no more. You've got a massive tricep. Yeah, that's nice. We've never seen the back of your legs look like that in an off season. That's exciting. Usually it looks very flat.
And maybe like.
I'm just more focused on your glutes. Even the top, you know, where you...
I'm trying to do this differently how I used to do it.
All right.
I think in prep, I started to go like that.
Yeah.
And it's like, instead of... Yeah, just making my rig out smaller.
I meant your glutes, but yeah.
How?
I meant your glutes.
Oh, okay. My bad, okay.
You know your glute mead? It looks rounder.
Yeah?
Yeah, it looks really good. Yeah, that's nice. You don't look as bloated as the other day either. No. you definitely are in much better body composition than last off season.
Yeah.
Last off season, we weren't out of shape, but.
No, but just. Yeah, I know what you mean.
There were just a lot more to come off in prep, weren't there?
Yes.
Whereas there's not this time.
It's really difficult because I feel like this last. I feel like PMDD has been PMDD. It's really fucking difficult, but it's like, if it's like that in my off season, it's like that in prep.
It never gets any better.
So I can't just avoid, like, I just have what my dad said in my head, like, last year.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you're gonna quit, you're gonna have this in off season and prep, so what, you're never gonna prep again? And yeah. It's like.
And then when you finish bodybuilding, it's still gonna be there.
So, it's difficult. I'm like even doubting my lift, so I really need to like try. Like, and then I look back and I'm like, perfect or good. it's been really tough.
I think we've only just added a new coil, so we can only see if that does anything to help it.
But I kind of thought that like having it in might like I might have a free moment like now, but yeah. It seems like not. But I guess. Just got to see how that goes, but my mindset is like prep in 5 weeks. It's giving me something to like count down.
Yeah, yeah.
And I would say, well, you could probably say as well. Even when I say it's shit, the sessions aren't like.
No, not at all.
Anytime you send me videos, then everything's decent. Good yeah. Numbers. So.
So.
It's more just mentally.
You just have to get yourself up so much more. Mentally when you're feeling like that, aren't you?
Yeah.
Whereas those 2 weeks you're feeling good, you're just like,
I'm a different person. Yeah. I always feel really bad like for her because I'm like, go Fiona. In her session, she's like, go Perry. And I'm like,
our own progress is our responsibility.
You don't need
it's,
to shout at each other.
No.
Yeah, it's at the end of the day, we could never say, oh, you know, you're like, because it's on us, isn't it? If we were on our own training,
yeah.
So it's on us now, it's just that extra little bit of support I think helps.
I think you make me shake it off though quicker, like, yeah. As in I think like, come on, you gotta fucking not be like this, otherwise I'll drag you like down or something like that. But
I think when you're with someone as well, you can't be in your own head too much, can you? Because you need to just keep yeah. Flowing yeah. Sessions. But
yeah, I think in terms of like prep, I do want to. I think I've definitely doubted myself like a lot on what my physique looks like, but I feel like that doubt is just more so when I'm where I am now.
Yeah,
that makes sense.
Yeah, yeah.
Literally. But yeah, it's yeah. I don't know. It's mad, isn't it? I just feel like
it's always the same though.
I know.
It's the same every 2 weeks. And if you want to go through bodybuilding, we've just got to try and manage. Yeah, we've got to try and manage it.
And I think having that 5 weeks. Whereas, can you imagine if you said, okay, I'm not prepping till next year, it would almost potentially make you slow down a little bit more, whereas you've only got 5 weeks, so you just need to put everything in no matter what's going on in here.
Yeah.
I think that's the mindset that you have got at the moment, so I think it's good.
Yeah, to be fair, like, you know, like I was marking my score for adherence and it would be like a 9 or something, just because I wasn't eating like 20 grams of ginger or like something like that. So it's not like my adherence is.
No, it's just like the little 1%
big time. It's like, yeah, but again, like saying, well, since we said how many weeks it was, I think it was from like 10 weeks or maybe something like that. It was kind of like when I got back from holiday, I managed to get back into it. So I feel a bit more confident in. How I look again now with actually being able to train. So, but I think the decision I kind of wanna, it's almost like I need like people to say, I think we should prep.
Well, I think you should prep, otherwise, I wouldn't have put it in your timeline.
Yeah, true, yeah.
And I think you should. And Mark thinks you should.
Mark thinks I should.
So, you just need to
do it.
The prep would probably be a bit nicer this time as well because you're both doing it together.
So yeah, I think basically it is going to be a go, so we'll have 5 weeks left of off-season, said it now. so I've just got to try and get this head in the right place, and that's it.
The progress is there.
Yeah, it is. I can definitely see it, although I keep being a psycho and comparing like loads of photos, but in the photos
that's just
comparing,
you.
I'm seeing better. You're so used to me now. Sometimes I'll be like typing something out and I'm like, Meg does not need this right now. Realistically, I think as much as I keep like looking at Asia and things like that, no, it literally used to be America now.
Yeah.
That's it. Because otherwise, if you qualify for the Olympia and you haven't been on an American stage, like, I just feel like you're not being out there like 3-4 times in a row versus nothing or just once. So I think it's literally, it needs to be America this year, or it's just like,
nice to get feedback from people that are going to be on the judging panel.
Exactly. So America.
Yeah. And it's not as if you were small on stage last year compared to the other girls. Yeah. I think a little bit more conditioning through the back from having more density would just be that like winning thing.
Yeah, exactly. So I think that's going to come.
If nothing happens this next month, I don't feel better mentally, I just get rid of it. And to be honest, the HRT didn't really do anything either, so I just not use anything.
Yeah, I think it was a really hard decision to make though, having that, and anything it is. Yeah. Like, I don't know about you, but like, I just like my body
to flow.
To be. Yeah. I think I've always been like that. Like,
if you hadn't tried it, I think I'd still be thinking, oh, I don't want to try it.
This could be like the best.
Yeah,
it really could.
Or just something that make a difference.
I always get people DM me and stuff, but there's been some people that have been like, this changed my life. It's the best. Like, bear with it. And then there's some people that have been like, yeah, really not good.
Yeah. We'll just have to see.
Exactly.
Some people work well with estrogen, some people work with progesterone really well. It's just got to find what works for you. The worst thing is that if you just run estrogen, you run the risk of high risk of cancer, so obviously we can't really do that.
See what happens.
If it doesn't do anything though, it needs to come out, because there's just no point in having it in. I'd just see what this cycle does.
Yeah.
If nothing gets better, it's not going to get better.
What would your reasoning for that be?
What, to get rid of it?
Yeah.
Because
just because it's not doing anything, or?
Yeah, and the fact that it most of the time stops people from getting as lean as what they can.
Oh. We don't need that.
No.
Okay. Okay, cool.
Yeah, lovely. Your glutes have definitely got loads bigger.
Oh, I just remembered something. Keep filming. I just remembered something. Fiona saw it earlier. Fiona starts prep today. I just got shivers. She saw this in my gym bag earlier and I just literally didn't say anything. But happy day one of prep.
This is going to get me through.
I think it's 25 quid or 21 so enjoy.
Thank you.
That's fine. No, good luck. So, yeah, she is literally amazing.
Oh, that's awesome.
Like I've said throughout, this thing that I have, PMDD, like, I don't know, it might go after this coil, like, I don't know, but right now I feel like it hasn't gone for all this time. It didn't go last off season, and as much as I like gave my all and turned up to every session, this year I feel like I've done more than turn up to my session. Like, I've had to like go, come on, like, you got to do this for you and Fiona. And for me, like, with this, like I've said before, I get up every day for Mark to do his stuff, and it makes me do mine. Like, and I don't know, Fiona even saw it earlier, like, I think I got to like rep 4 on my set or something, and I'm like, I can't be bothered, I want to put it down, but I'm like, no, come on, like, if I start being negative and not doing things, like, it's going to rub off, and this is my training partner, and I want her to excel. So a massive thank you to you, because
I think it's changed it for both of us though.
It's making like massive progress, and I don't think that I would make the same progress.
Yeah. Like, likewise.
Without it. So,
yeah, likewise. Yeah,
that's a big thank you. And you're competing in 23 weeks and 6 days.
End of August.
And basically, obviously, you just overheard the whole conversation. I've got 5 weeks left, 4 weeks, 6 days, until I start prep. So I'm just going to put that out there now. Unless I really decide that, like, mentally I can't. But the way I see it, like I said on the when Meg was here, like, at the moment, the way I see it is, this thing is here to stay. Like, it's here to stay. And like my dad said last year, if you quit prep, you're just going to have this in your off season anyway. So you learn to live with it. You control it instead of let it control you. And I don't want to have that, like Meg said, like from a physique standpoint, like I've improved, I've made the improvements. She wouldn't have mapped my, like she wouldn't have mapped it out for me to compete. So like, it's just, I've got to try and like get there mentally. Now for me mentally, like I do everything every single day. I adhere to everything, vacuums, like, I don't know.
You're
everything,
a bodybuilder.
Steps. Yeah, all, yeah, all the food. Like,
it's just your life, isn't it? It's your routine.
Literally everything is just there. So as, if you said to me tomorrow, you're starting prep, like all that would change is the calories. Like other than that, nothing would change. So yeah, I'm going to take you guys through the rest of this 5 weeks. It's, I feel like I've just got back to a place. I think I'm 14 or 15 weeks post show. I think I've just got back to a place where I might have trained now for 4 or 5 weeks consistently, I think it is, mm-hmm. 4 or 5 weeks. So we've got 5 weeks left. So before that, there was like minimal training and not really much going on. And that's why I've not really done like a YouTube before now. So yeah, we've got 5 weeks. I'm gonna take you through it. You've seen my physique now. I will be on this every single week and that's it. So yeah, it's time to do this.
Exciting.
Let's go.
Yeah. Together.